is not a provider of the primary needs of customers, because most of those needs are consumptive in nature. There are other providers of those primary needs, but the bank is there as a conduit through which customers can access what they need on a day-to-day basis. Retail bankers are facing stiff competition from non-providers of financial services, from retailers, from utilities. One of the key competitive areas is the loyalty programs that retailers and utilities come up with. Recently, I read that Pick and Pay here have spent billions of rands in coming up with a customer loyalty program. In essence, a customer loyalty program is an invasion of the traditional savings bank in a way. Because what is happening is retailers will price their goods very cleverly in such a way that they take into account a component from the customer's money that will be saved for use to buy the products from the retailer on a future date. That is essentially a savings account packaged differently. There is more and more competition that is coming from non-traditional providers of financial services. In the UK in particular, we have seen some models such as the one pursued by Tesco, where they are providing that one-stop convenience through their usual distribution channel that enables a customer to access retail banking products, insurance products, and various other products at the point where the customer can access their primary needs. I think Kenya should teach us some lessons where when M-Pesa started, I think Safaricom did not get cooperation from the banks. And what is happening now is I think every bank is trying to court them because they have stolen a large chunk of the non-funded income from the traditional banking institutions because of their M-Pesa product. And I understand a number of other countries, including Zimbabwe, are also in the process of trying to copy the model that was developed or that was implemented in Kenya through M-Pesa. I think going forward, banks must seamlessly integrate their delivery channels with the channels of the providers of goods and services that meet the customer's primary needs. In the place of the traditional channels that are used to deliver cash, banks must more and more integrate with retailers through cashback facilities so that they share the risk of keeping cash in their branches and customers can access cash where they need to buy the goods that they require. The branches should become smaller and smaller going forward and should operate more as a launch base from which service can be delivered and as a customer service center. Banking institutions must have a robust cost sharing model where they can reduce their operating costs by sharing costs with utilities and retailers, as they will share the delivery channels as well. The reason we've got a large population of unbanked people in Africa is because retail bankers have not tried to make their service rendering of relevance to that culture. If banks had silos in the place of some banking branches, if they had crawls and paddocks in the place of other banking branches where people can keep a cattle that they want to serve, other forms of assets, I would like to believe that we would be able to reduce the number of the unbanked quite drastically. In summary, I would like to share the model that we are implementing at TN Bank. We did a reverse takeover of a furniture company. The furniture company we took over is the largest both in terms of manufacturing and retailing in Zimbabwe. Then we integrated our banking branches within the furniture branches. So you find a cubicle or an in-store bank within the furniture shop. And within the same shop, you will find we had a strategic arrangement with the Econet Wireless, the largest mobile telephone company in Zimbabwe, where they will also sell their telecom products from the same branch, and there is a pharmacy within the same branch. So that a customer walks in there, the bank is there to deliver their money where they need it to buy drugs, to deliver their money where they need it to buy telecoms products, and to underwrite any credit that they might require if they need to buy any of the products on credit. And by the same vein, we've also entered into a strategic relationship with USAID and Save the Children, whereby we are using our technology as a vehicle through which we are delivering convenience to rural folk through the smart card technology. We realize that NGOs are a major threat to retail banking, as they seek to deliver aid, financial aid, through channels other than traditional banking channels. So to anticipate that erosion of our market share, we have sought to partner them and to act as a delivery channel. And in my view, that is really the future of banking. We should seek to move away from seeking to give customers a retail banking experience and move more towards integrating with providers of goods and products that people need on a day-to-day basis. If we can do so so seamlessly and efficiently, then we will be guaranteed that the space that a retail bank occupies will not be eroded. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.